five. But what you need to understand is a fairly significant amount of what you see has actually been rebuilt. It's not what they found here. So what you have is, and you will see this consistently now as you go through the land, you'll see this kind of thing, and somewhere you'll begin to see this kind of line in the walls of these ruins. Understand archaeology is maybe become an armchair archaeologist. So when you walk up and you say, what's here and what was here, that's the archaeologist, based on their scholarship and expertise, that's how they reconstructed it. And then below it, that's what they found.
Okay, all right. Welcome to about 300 meters above sea level, which is about 1,000 feet. Beersheba, an archaeological excavation, there have been a couple of different times that are excavated here, but the oldest findings go here to the 4th millennium BC, almost 6,000 years back. And from there on further. Now, in the Bible, Beersheba is mentioned many, many times. Actually, if you count, 33 times. It is especially mentioned with the patriarch, Abraham, Isaac, Jacob. With all of them, Beersheba is mentioned. As Bill told, one of the first things was Abraham Abimelech, the servant who were fighting for source of water for their sheep and goats. Eventually, the oak was 37. So when the wells are made, let's not fight about it. One of the interesting things, just before we enter, we have a well here. Huge well. It goes more than 100 feet down. What period of time it is exactly? Whenever you have an archaeological site, there's always argument among the archaeologists. But anyway, it's very old well in the Beersheba. Tradition calls it the well of Abraham. Is it that one? We don't know. The tradition says a little bit. Where else? You remember the story when Abraham is sent to take his son Isaac to go to the Mount of Moriah, to the land of Moriah. We will probably be talking about this a little bit later. Let's remember Jerusalem. After now, Beersheba is considered in the Bible, when we can assess the tribal area, that is the area of the tribe of Judah. It was kind of the end of cultivation. And whenever you talk in the Bible, from the north to the south, so you get the sentence from John to the center. That's kind of the calculating area, because when you start going south, that way, that's the east, that's the east. In this area, how can you live here, by the way, if you look around? It is kind of desert-like, but if you look down here, there's one river going down here. There is actually another river that is coming from those mountains, another Pierpont mountain. These, when it's raining, in this specific area, it rains about 200 milliliters, which is 20 centimeters, which is 7 feet inches a year. But when you go a little bit higher, the water starts coming out. So they knew also to use the waters that are passing close by and collecting them. And although the one place when we go in, you actually see one of the big water cisterns that are collecting this water from the streams around this area. But many, many different layers of time have been found here. As I said, the oldest one goes 6,000 years back in history. Then there's a big gap. They didn't find a lot, so for 2,000 years of nothing, still didn't find. Maybe one day they will. And then we come to the area, so-called Iron Age, the Israeli times, David, Solomon, kings of Judah. From that period of time, they start finding things in here as well. From that period of time, also the wall, this wall that is here, is considered to be from the Judean kings. The city did suffer from earthquakes. Suggested the Bible, the book of Amos, it talks about an earthquake. Some suggest that that is actually the earthquake that did destroy part of the Shema. It was rebuilt. The Assyrians, 700s BC, conquered the area, again destroyed. Again, it's rebuilt partially. Afterwards, you get the Greeks, the Romans, so all of them kind of left some marks in this area. And after them, it starts spreading around a little bit outside from this place. Okay. What we'll do, first of all, we'll take a look down. Well, you enter the city gate, we'll go up those steps. There's a nice view of the whole area. And then, if people want, we'll go up there. Look at the water cisterns.